Colorectal cancer is a very important cancer because it's second leading cancer in men and the third leading cancer in women. So it's very, very important to treat patients with colorectal cancer. Around about 60 to 70% of patients develop metastases in the liver during their disease. We think that around about 15% of the patients have synchronous liver metastases, and around about 15% develop only metachronic liver metastases. And those groups are potential group for interventional radiologists. But I think it's a wild field for the interventional radiologist. We've just heard about the radiofrequency ablation, microwave ablation. We heard about the local therapy like chemoembolization, chemoperfusion, or the yttrium 90 therapy with SIRT.
The main advantage of interventional oncology with these three different treatments is that we can perfectly combine this treatment with other more established treatments, like, for example, systemic treatment. Like in the CLOCK trial, systemic treatment plus ablation improved dramatically the survival of selected patients. The ablation has also some limitations. The patient has to be selected. That's the reason we have a multidisciplinary approach to select the patient that is really the best patient for the different interventional oncological modalities.
We can expand indications for surgery, and there are new options in that field where we can increase the volume of the future remnant liver after surgery. We know now that for colorectal mets of small size, below 3 cm, we can provide similar results to hepatic resection with lower morbidity and mortality. And we also have palliative options that do have to find a place in the whole armamentarium of chemotherapy.
In the CLOCK trial, we have clear results that the combination of surgery and radiofrequency aplasty improves the survival of the patient. We have now the 8-year results, and there's a large discrepancy between just chemotherapy and the combination of surgery and radiofrequency. I think, yes, the future will be the combination.
If you want to play a role, you have to be in the guidelines. And for the first time this year, the guidelines of the ESMO, the European Society of Medical Oncology, do include, at a certain point, the IO techniques. So they are officially recommended or accepted in the treatment of patients with colorectal mets for the first time. So it's a big change for us. We have to work together with the other specialties, because all of us have good indications, bad indications, and in a patient perspective, we have to find the best for each patient.
European Congress of Interventional Oncology is really working on the absolutely right way, of course. We have a lot of surgeons, we have a lot of oncologists, we have radiation therapists, and not only as guests, but also in the faculty.
Today, if you want to be able to discuss with oncologists and surgeons, you must not only know your specialty, your results, but you must also be aware of their results. And this is what we have here, actually. In every single session, we have a radiotherapist, we have a medical oncologist, they are presenting their results, the most recent ones. So in terms of knowledge, I think this kind of event is quite valuable for every single participant.